morning.
Good morning to you.
Evening, really. Yeah, just a dead quick question. As a new carbine shooter, which I am, in 22, what should I be doing at the range? Because what I'm doing at the minute is I've got a 25-yard range, and I'm putting 150 rounds in a 6x6 target, and that's pretty dull.
Right.
It's not a dynamic range.
Hold on. I have a couple questions. Number one, do you have limitations on your range? You know, are you able to move, or do you have to stay stationary?
It's a station.
Stationary. All right. Can you change positions, elevation, like standing, kneeling, sitting, prone?
Yes.
All right. Good. All right. Third one. Well, what'd you say? Are you shooting 22, or you started shooting in 22? You said a car
22 caliber. Yeah.
All right. 22 caliber. All right. So because you're limited with movements and stuff, you definitely want to work on mechanics, manipulation. I don't know what platform you're using, but mechanics.
AR.
Yes. Yeah. All right, cool. Oh, good. AR and 22, badass, right on. So you definitely want to work those mechanics. I mean, it's good brain food, you know, because you want mechanics to work at an absolute intuitive level, subconscious level driven tasks. But you need a lot of freaking reps in order for that to happen. Another thing is marksmanship is boring, but it's absolutely freaking essential. And you could kind of develop your own set of like standards, for instance, like I just said, standing, sitting, kneeling, prone. And what range do you have? 25 or further?
Yeah.
25? So that's not far. So get out of the prone and don't go bench resting because you don't need that distance. But I would set up a set of standards where you shoot, for instance, whatever target you're using, let's say it's a scorable B8 target. I don't know what you're using, but it's scorable. So it's got the rings. It's got a 10 ring, 9, 8, 7, maybe 6, 5. Set up a standard where you shoot 10 from a standing, 10 from a kneeling, 10 from a sitting, 10 from a prone. Record your score. Each round is worth 10 points. How many rounds you say you were shooting when you go?
I normally get 3 boxes, so 150.
150, all right, yep, you're right. Good. So that's 50 rounds. You don't even have to do 10s. You could do 5s, but that right there is 40, right? So that's a 400-point aggregate if you're using a bullseye with a 10-ring zone, because each round is worth 10 points. But so you want to set up that set of standards, and I think – I think early days on the Patreon site, I put up some position shooting. Did I? And if not, I could always do that, because your score is going to progressively get better based on, of course, improving marksmanship, but then little shit like nickel and diming your positions and how you build a position to achieve an actual point of aim and how you lock in and all that stuff. But that's those two things right there is what I would do. Build your own set of standards and work on those mechanics, bro. Yeah. Perfect. Because you're limited. You know, you're limited.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Yeah, cool. Good. Yeah. And then ping me anytime. If you need like a quick, hey, send me 2 freaking stationary courses of fire that I could call my
own. I will. Yeah. I've been speaking to Rick Harg a few times.
Oh, good. Well. Yeah. Good. Good.
He might even do a little video for me on the 22.
Good.
Awesome. You know, because he understands our kind of problems that we've got with our calibers. So.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks very much for that.
Absolutely. Really easy breezy.
Cheers. Nice one. Right on.